Hello guys, how are you today? Today our lesson is about gas exchange. Before we start our lesson, I want you to subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell, and if you have any comments, please write them down. So let's know how does respiration takes place. So air enters into the lungs, air enters into the body through the nose, mouth, and then pharynx, and then trachea. And the trachea is divided into smaller two branches called the bronchus, and the bronchus divides into bronchioles and finally reaches to the blood capillaries where gas exchange takes place. Let's look at the other diagram. Here we have the air enters into the nose, trachea, and then forming, dividing into two bronchus, and the bronchus into bronchioles, and then finally reaches the alveoli, and where gas exchange takes place, where we have here blood capillaries. Gas exchange is the delivery of oxygen from the lungs to the bloodstream, and the elimination of carbon dioxide from the bloodstream to the lungs. It occurs in the lungs between the alveoli and the capillaries, which are located in the walls of the alveoli. Let's look at how does gas exchange takes place at the alveolus. Oxygen passes into the lungs, or air enters into the alveolus, is filled with oxygen. Okay, and a higher so the air enter into the lungs is contains higher concentration of oxygen and low concentration of carbon dioxide. So the air passes into the lungs containing oxygen, and oxygen diffuses into the bloodstream and combines with the hemoglobin in the red blood cells, forming a compound called oxyhemoglobin. So here the concentration in the bloodstream is high in oxygen and low in carbon dioxide. So oxygen here is transported around the body by the red blood cell. Well, let's look at the other side. Here the red blood cells are filled with carbon dioxide, and they combine with hemoglobin in the red blood cell to form carboxyhemoglobin, and the carbon dioxide then here leaves this bloodstream and then passes into the alveolus by diffusion. as we know that diffusion is the movement of particles from higher concentration to lower concentration. Okay, and then the carbon dioxide is expelled out of the body from the alveolus and then out of the body. Okay, so as we know that this process is very necessary for us to keep us alive. Let's look at closer look. This is the capillary here, and these are the red blood cells, and the oxygen diffuses into the red blood into the blood capillaries, and then combines with the hemoglobin in the red blood cell, and then carbon dioxide diffuses out of the red blood cell into the alveolus. Okay, this is a very close diagram. I hope that our lesson today was of help to you. If you have any comments, please write them down, and please subscribe to my channel. And if you have any questions, please write them down. Subscribe to my channel for.